All right. Good afternoon, class. Before we start, I have a question. I want you to tell something about the picture. Sige, ulitin natin. Tell me something about the picture. Just pretend you don't know the answer. Tell something about it. Raise hand. Sino nag-raise ng hand? Dulay.
Si Ana, about Dominos.
Para about kung, Dominos. Okay, about Dominos na may kamay.
Yun. Yes.
Okay, next. Who else? Eronico.
Ano po? Parang pinipigilan niyo po yung domino effect po.
Okay, pinipigilan yung domino because of the hand. Oh, merong yes, naka, may naka-barred na hand. Who else? Last one. Kyle. Speak up. What can you say about the picture? Turn on your speaker. Wala. Who likes to answer this question? Tell me something about this picture. Oh yes, Adrian.
Sir, pinipigilan po yung continuation ng domino.
Okay, pinipigilan yung continuation nung pagbagsak ng domino. So our topic is about, starts with letter C. It's, nasabi niya na, continuation or continuity. So our topic for today is the continuity of a function. And I am your teacher in Basical, Mr. Jeffrey John G. De Leon. Continuity of a function. Our objectives are, you as a learner should be able to illustrate continuity of a function at the number. Number two, determine whether a function is continuous at the number or not. Number three, illustrate continuity of a function on an interval. And number four, solve problems involving continuity of a function. Okay. What is the continuity of a function at constant C? So a function is said to be continuous at x equals c. C here is constant, no? If there is no interruption in the graph of a function at C, there is no hole, there's no jump, nor gap, okay, at x equals C. So upon tracing the graph of a function, you're not going to lift your pen at x equals C. So once you lift your pen, it means that the graph of a function is discontinuous at x equals C. So let's try to look at the following example. So malinaw naman yung x yung definition niya. But when we look at illustrative examples, we will see clearly kung anong ibig sabihin ito. So example number one, look at this graph. It is a linear graph. When you trace it using a pen from one point to the other without lifting it, it means the function is continuous. Okay? So can you see the cursor? So for example, from this point, x is negative 2. For example, 2, x equals 4. From negative 2 to 4. If I'm going to trace this graph without lifting my pen, oops, there's a hole. It means I can go to number 4, but I will lift my pen. And so therefore, this function, this linear graph is not continuous. Is that clear? Hindi siya continuous kasi may hole. Okay? How about number two? As you can see, if you trace the graph from a certain point to the other point, oh, look at that. Up to one, and then nag-jump ka na para lang makapunta sa other graph. So there's a gap. Hindi continuous. Number two is also a non-continuous. Nakuha? And number three is this one. What kind of function is this? Anyone? We have different functions. Linear function, quadratic function. sino makakapagsabi ko anong klaseng function to? Starts with letter A. Correct. Na pizza, that's correct. Absolute value function. This is an absolute value function. So, if you try to trace this, you can notice that we are going to trace and you're not going to lift the pen at any value at x. So, if these are the values of x, walang ano dyan, walang gap or walang space. Kaya this one is a continuous function. Is that clear? Okay, next. Activity 1. Activity 1 agad kayo. So, on page 24, learning task number 1, you're going to determine which graph is continuous and which is not. So, napakadali. Kaya explain ko lang, kayang-kaya nyo na yung sagutan. Number 1, halos may katulad doon sa example ko. Number 2, what kind of function is this? What kind of function is this? Number 2. It's a sinusoidal function, no? So meaning, it's a sine function, it's a trigonometric function. And this one, it's a parabolic in shape. Parabola, therefore it's a quadratic function. Okay? So sabihin nyo lang dyan kung continue siya or hindi. Okay, next. Plus, before we start graphing more functions, I want you to download this in your tablet or any gadget. Kung kaya nyong simultaneous, gagawin sa inyong mga laptop or desktop, much better. Pero kailangan nyo talaga ng dalawang gadget dito kasi nag-aaral tayo sa laptop. Tapos, kung meron kayong smartphone, Android phone, paki-download to. Ito ang icon niya, Desmos. Tapos ganito yung makikita ninyo. Okay? So please remember this, Desmos app. Okay, graph the following functions using the Desmos app. So tandaan natin itong mga i-graph natin. 1, 2, 3, 4 function, linear. This is rational function. And number 3 is quadratic kasi may square tayo dito eh. So let's move on to the Desmos app. I'll show you what's the Desmos app. Can you see this one? Can you see the app now? Not yet.
Hindi pa po. Yung presentation niya pa rin po, sir.
Hindi, dapat yung Desmos app na ang makikita niyo. Hold on. Ayan. Okay. So, this is the Desmos.com. I'm using my laptop to show you how to graph this for examples. So, example number 1. Ano nga example number 1 natin? Y equals negative x plus 1. So, I write y. Remember, class f of x is also the same as y. Magtakayo, saan galing yung y? F of x is same as y. So, y equals negative x plus 1. So, nasaan ang ating, ayun, ang ating graph. Okay? So, using this Desmos, you can easily visualize what kind of graph your equation is. Okay? It's a linear graph. Therefore, this is a linear function. Okay? How about number 2? Yung binigay kong example, that is y equals x minus 1. Good. Okay? It's also a linear graph. Therefore, it's a linear function. Okay? How about number 3? We have a rational function. Y equals 1 over x minus 2. So, pindutin natin yung divide. Okay? So, we have 1 over x minus 2. X minus 2. Saan na siya? Ayun. Okay? In kulay purple. It's a rational function. Okay, ganyan ay itsura ng mga rational graph. Okay, dalawahan. And number 4, anong itsura nito? Number 4, y equals x squared. Ito yung second problem natin. X squared minus 2. Ayan, color black. It's a quadratic function. Okay? because it's a parabola. Okay, look at that. So simulan natin sa number one. So this number one. Ano ba i-hide to? X na nga lang. Ayan. Look at number one. Continuous or not? It's continuous. Is it continuous? Class, yes, be careful. Ma'am. Be careful kayo kung continuous or hindi ha. Titingnan nyo siya, ayan o, yung ginagawa ko. Kung may hole. Kasi minsan may hole yan. Katulad niyan. Oops. So may value ba? May value ba? For every values of x, may value ba si y? Ayan, halimbawa. Halimbawa ito. Ang x ko rito ay negative 5. Anong value ni y? 6. So, halimbawa, dito, ang aking x ay 0. Anong value ni y? 1. So wala tayong hole. Wala tayong hole, blankong hole. Okay? Ayan o, may mga value siya. Okay, number 2, we have x minus 1. Look at the x minus 1. So if you will trace that, class, sana malino yung ano, no? O, may mga value siya. When x is 0, y is negative 1. When y is 1, I'm sorry, when x is 1, y is 0. So ganyan yan. So may mga value siya. Okay? So this is also a continuous function. How about number 3? Ang number 3 natin ay rational function. 1 over, so divide yan, ano? I'm sorry. 1 divided by x minus 2. Tingnan yung mabuti. Wait, trace nyo yung graph na yan. Meron ba tayong gap or hole or anything? Meron, syempre. From a certain point, going to another point, there is a gap. Hindi mo maitutuloy yan. You're going to lift your pen. Right? So number 3 example is not continuous function. And number 4, we have x squared minus 2. X squared minus 2. Oh, look at that. Oh, lahat ng value ni x, merong y. Kuha? So, number 4 is also a continuous function. This is the Desmos app. So, I want you to download this para pag yung may mga mabibigat kayong problems, mas ma-visualize nyo kung anong klaseng graph po. Okay? Minsan, meron tayong quartic graph. Try nga natin yung quartic. Okay, magbigay tayo. When you say, yes, quartic. Power 3. Paano pag ganyan? Look at that. Okay? Ang itsura niya, parang hindi maintindihan, parang nagsasayaw. So y equals x cubed minus 3 is also a continuous function. Okay? So paki-download yan para maganda tayo. Okay, next. So nalaman na natin itong mga to. Okay, using the Desmos app. Ngayon, activity 2 nyo on page 24, graph the following functions using the Desmos app and determine which of the following is continuous and which is not. So answer 1 to 4 only. For 5 and 6, it's a bonus on a problem. If you can graph it using the Desmos app, much better. Look at this. What kind of function is this? It's a piecewise function. It's a piecewise function. It's a bonus kapag nasagutan niyo yung 5 and 6. All right? So this is for your activity 2. Let's move on. The 3 conditions of continuity. Yes, Jordan. Class, sinesend ko naman yung ano. Kung may screenshot niyo, okay lang din. Pero isa-send ko naman itong recorded video. Okay? So, para mabalikan niyo siya. So, the 3 conditions of continuity. A function f of x is said to be continuous at x equals c if the following 3 conditions are satisfied. So, tandaan niyo yung tatlong condition na to. Okay, first, f of c exists. Okay, what do you mean by f of z exists? Yan yung isi-substitute nyo lang yung value ng constant nyo dun sa equation nyo. Number 2, the limit of a function when X approaches C, exist also. Okay? And number three, if f of c equals the limit of a function as x approaches c equals the limit of f of c as x approaches c are the same when this equals this one. So meaning, continuous ang ating function. Pag may isa dyan na nag-fail, hindi na siya continuous. Okay? Let's try an example. If at least one of these conditions is not met, the function said to be discontinuous at x equals c. Example number one. Determine if f of x equals x squared minus 2x plus 3 is continuous at x equals 1. Okay. Itinan natin dun sa x. The value of x, when the value of x equals 1, continuous kaya siya. O, gamitan nyo ng ano? Gamitan nyo mamaya ito ng Desmos. Or mamaya papakita uli natin kung sa, when x is equal to 1 ba, may hole ba doon? Diretso ba siya or what? So, using the three conditions, okay, if x equals 1, handa nyo to. Ayan o, if fc exists, the limit exists, at saka yung dalawa equal. Yung a, sorry, this is b. When b equals a, this is a, okay? So, kailangan yung tatlo mag-satisfy. Okay, if x is equal to 1, then f of 1 equals 2. Paano naging 2? When f equals 1, this is your c, oh. So substitute all the x's with 1. So 1 square minus 2 times 1 plus 3. What is the answer? 1 squared minus 2 times 1. So 1 minus 2 is negative 1 plus 3. Negative 1 plus 3 is 2. So letter A, the answer is 2. Condition letter A, 2. Condition B. Tingnan natin condition B. The limit of this function as x approaches 1. Ha, 1 ang pinag-uusapan natin. Eh, you know, continuous at 1. So again, substitute this value here. 1 minus 2x plus 3 equals, what's the answer? 1 minus 2 plus 3, 2. Therefore, f of 1 equals, ito yun, yung letter A, f of 1 equals the limit. Okay, when A and B are the same, if they are equal, then therefore, ABC satisfy the condition, this is a continuous function. May question ba doon? Any question? Plus, just plug in the values here. Ah. Yun lang, ganun lang kadali yun. Okay? Number two. Therefore, f is continuous at x equals 1. Number 2, determine if the function x squared minus 3x plus 2 over x minus 2 is continuous at x equals 0. Condition A, if x is 0, 0 ang pinag-usapan natin. Ha? So, f 0 equals negative 1. Paano nangyari yun? O doon, substitute natin yung 0 daw dito. 0 here. 0 minus 0 plus 2. 0 minus 0 plus 2 is positive 2. Positive 2 sa numerator over 0 minus 2 is negative 2. So we have 2 over negative 2 is negative 1. Okay? The answer, condition A, is negative 1. Letter B, the limit of the function as x approaches 0. So ganyan ang gagawin natin, ha, class. Okay? Ganyan. We factorize the numerator into x minus 2, x minus 1. Why? Kasi class, hindi agad tayo basta, pag limits ang pinag-uusapan, ha? Letter B, okay? Hindi tayo basta plug in ang plug in, ha? Kasi baka mamaya, indeterminate form pala siya. Indeterminate form, yan yung pinag-aral natin last week. Kaya, mas safe na magpa-factorize tayo kung possible. So, in this case, pinactorize siya, cancel, x minus 2, x minus 2, what left is x minus 1, then substitute 0 here, 0 minus 1 is negative 1. Now, A is negative 1, B is negative 1, therefore C, F0 equals the limit of a function, x is approaches 0. And therefore, F is continuous at x equals 0. Okay? Ulitin ko lang to, ha, itong part na to. Pwede nyo naman i-substitute agad ng walang factoring. Substitute nyo, katulad yung ginawa nyo na sa letter A. Diba? Pares na pares lang. Substitute nyo yung 0, lalabas negative 1. Ganun din dito. Substitute nyo lahat yung 0, lalabas negative 1. Bakit pa ako na ganito? Kaya lang, ang tinasabi ko, mas safe na nag-factorize tayo kasi pag nadapa tayo ng indeterminate form, magkakamali kayo. Okay? How about let example number 3? Look at example number 3. What's the difference between example number 3 and 2?
Yung sa ano difference? For me po, sir, yung sa number 3 po.
Number?
Number 3 po.
Yes, it's indeterminate. Correct. Why? Tingnan nyo, the value of x is 2. O pag sinatitute mo siya dyan, the limit will be what? What will happen to the limit? 2 minus 2, 0. The denominator can't be 0. The denominator can't be 0. Magiging it does not exist. Magiging dn ito. Tama? Kaya yan. So, simulan natin itong example number 3. Okay. If x equals 2, then f2 does not exist. Substitute nyo nga dyan. Letter A, ah. Substitute nyo si 2 here. Lahat dyan sa mga. Dito pa lang, 0 na siya. How about sa limit? The limit of a function as x approaches 2 equals, anong ginawa niya rito? Yan, nag-factorize na siya. Nag-cancel-cancel to. Natira yung x minus 1. So, substitute mo ngayon si 2 here sa x. 2 minus 1 is 1. Now, isang A is does not exist. Letter B is 1. What can you say about C? They are not equal. Okay, ito yung A, does not exist. Ito yung B, equals to 1. Since they are not equal, therefore, the function, or f, is not continuous at x equals 2. Malinaw ba yun? Sana malinaw yun, ha? Yes, that's our the third example. So, activity 3, on page 28, okay? Learning task number 4, I want you to prove using the three conditions. Oops, daray ko. Using the three conditions of continuity, if the following function is continuous or not on a given constant C. So, anong gagawin nyo dyan? Okay, so, check the three conditions A, B, and C. Okay, para masabi nyo continuous function siya or not continuous. Look at number 4, negative 5. What will happen when you substitute it here? It will become 0. Indeterminate, kaya dapat may gagawin kayo dyan. Okay, that's for activity 3. And last one, continuity of a function on an interval. Okay, a function f is said to be continuous from the left at x is equal to z, c, if fc equals the limit of a function as x approaches c from the left. That's how you read it, ah. You have negative 1 here. Sorry, negative, not negative 1. Negative meaning from the left of C. And likewise, C plus meaning from the right of C. Okay? Continuity of function on an interval. So let's have this example. Consider graph on this side. Determine if the function is continuous on the following intervals. Class, I hope alam nyo yung difference ni parenthesis kesa bracket, ha? Magkaiba si parenthesis kay bracket. When you say parenthesis, meaning, what do you mean by parenthesis? It's an open hole. Okay? How about the bracket? When you say bracket, when you see this bracket, it means this number is included. Close siya, no hole at all. Unlike yung negative 1, consider mo yung negative 1 is not included. Pag bracket, 0 is included. Here, 3 bracket, meaning 3 is included. Let's see, paano to? Negative 1, from negative 1, this is the graph of the function, from negative 1 going to 2. But negative 1 is not included, ha? And positive 2 is not included. Basta dito ka lang magsisimula. Pag ganun. Tinetrace mo siya hanggang 2. Nag-stop na ako dito sa 2. Okay? So again, from negative 1, traced it using your pen papunta sa 2, nag-lift ba yung pen mo? May hole ka bang dinaanan? Wala. And so therefore, what is this? A continuous or not? It is a continuous. It's continuous. Okay? Number or letter B. From 0, including 0, ibig sabihin yan, including 0, up to 3, including 3. So from 0, ito yung 0 ko, papunta sa 3, including 3, ha? Okay, let's graph it. Hanggang 3. Kaya lang, pagdating natin ng 3, sabi dito kasi, including 3, hole. Makakarating ka ba doon? Of course not. Kasi hole nga siya, aangat ang kamay mo, ang pen mo, pagdating mo dun sa point, yung point na yon sa 3. And therefore, letter B is not continuous. Malinaw ba? Let's try number or letter C. From negative 4, not including negative 4, to negative 1. Where's negative 4? Here. From this point up to negative 1. Papunta sa negative 1. Oops. Mistop na tayo. Mistop ba tayo? Pupunta tayo dito. Titignan mo yung graph eh. Continuous or not continuous?
Not.
Why not?
Kasi sir, hindi po connectado yung line.
Oh, yes. Correct. Obviously, hindi naman siya connected. Kaya not continuous yan. From negative 4, papunta dun sa negative 1. Nag-jump ka na. Sabi, bawal ang jump. Papunta sa negative 1. So, hindi siya continuous. And number, and letter D, what's this? What's the answer in letter D? Negative 2 to 3. Negative 2. Ito, negative 2. Papunta sa 3. Continuous or not?
Not.
Why, Kenzie?
Sir, kasi po doon sa 0.1, nag-up po yung pen.
Or hindi ha. Naka-close yan eh. Hindi siya open hole. Close yan, no? Blacken. Na-blacken siya, oh. This is close. So, walang ano yan. Walang gap dyan. Okay, so meaning, letter D is continuous. Nakuha ba? So for the activity number 4, page 27, I want you to identify if the given function is continuous on a given interval. Okay? Sige, sagutan na kaya natin to. Kayo magsagot. From negative 7, ito yung negative 7. Negative 7 to negative 3. Tingnan natin, ha? Negative 7 to negative 3. Ito yung negative 7. Whoop! Hanggang negative 3. Ano kayong sagot dyan? I don't know.
Continuous.
I don't know. Tingnan natin. How about negative 5 to negative 3? Oh, negative 3, close bracket. Meaning kasama si negative 3, ha? So, negative 5. Ito yun, negative 5. So, start ka rito, papunta sa negative 3, including negative 3. Kasi nakabracket siya. So, dapat alam yan. How about 0 to 3? Including 0 hanggang 3. O, included din yung 3. Continuous or not continuous? I don't know. Number 4, from 3 to 7. 3 hanggang dito sa 7 on the graph. Tumalo, no? Kayo na bahala dyan. And number 5, negative 5, ito yon, negative 5, up to 5. Ah, alam na, kung ang dami ng tinalunan. So, yun yung activity number 4 natin. Okay, on page 27. So, ganun lang kadali ang ating week ngayon. Para naman mapagbigyan ng time yung mga hindi pa gumagawa ng week 1 activities. Tapusin nyo na. Itong week 2 natin, mamadaling-madali lang. Hindi ko na kayo masyadong pinahirapan pa. Alright, may question ba tayo? Siguro magbigay pa tayo ng isang example ng not continuous. Let's try this one. Let's see this. Punta tayo sa Desmos. Okay. Punta tayo sa Desmos natin. Continuous. Task 3. Nawala yung equation natin. O sige, simulan natin itong ano. Subukan natin yung example number 3 natin kanina. Ito yung example number 3 natin kanina. Divide x squared minus 3x plus 2. Break. Over. Ito example number 3 natin kanina. X minus 2. Ayan. Look at that. Tingnan niyo siya. Is this a continuous function or not continuous? Zoom pa kaya natin siya. Zoom natin. Yeah. Zoom. Magsabi niyo, continuous siya or hindi? Kung titingnan niyo sa graph, parang continuous siya, no? Pero tingnan niyo, oh, ayan natin, tingnan natin kung sa hindi to continuous eh. May value ang y when x is 0. May value din ng y when x is 1. Nasa nawala yung ano. Ayun, may undefined. Oh. When x is 2, nakikita nyo ba? When x is 2, y is undefined. Why? Kasi itong portion na to, hindi lang masyadong visible, pero whole siya. Ayan o, whole. Binigay naman niya yung value pati. 2, undefined. Okay. Ito yung example number 3 natin na not continuous kasi nga hindi na met yung 3 conditions natin. Nakuha ba? Hindi niya na met yung 3 conditions. Yung first condition niya, when f equals 2, does not exist. Yung letter B, solving the limit, the answer is 1. So magkaiba sila. Kaya itong problem na to is a not continuous function. Okay, yan yung paggamit ng Desmos natin. So, may tanong pa ba tayo? I-download nyo sa mga ano nyo yan para ma-visualize nyo yung mga graphs ninyo. Okay? Any question? Walang question? So, meron bang mapapasa ng ano pa? May mga na-checkan na ako sa week 1. Pakipasa na yung hindi pa nagpapasa sa week 1. Week 2 hanggang mamaya. Alright? Nag-attendance na ako. Meron bang late? Nadyan ba si Lozada? Wala. Balba and Barzaga? Wala rin. Okay, so kung wala nang tanong, I'll see you again next Monday. Okay? So thank you, class.
Thank you, sir. Bye.